The current movie meta is something that has fascinated me recently. I started rewatching the movie Bullet Train on Netflix and I realized, damn, this is cool. It's kind of long. I also had the same feeling watching the new John Wick film in theaters. It made me think about the current movie meta. Your movie doesn't need to be 3 hours long. Please, you're not special. I don't care if it's Batman, Spider-Fuck, or Supercum. It doesn't mean you have to have a movie the same length as a root canal. The average movie length has gotten significantly longer over the years, but it's become more noticeable recently. I feel like the biggest culprit to blame is the one movie that started this new fetish for 3 hour long movies, Pretenders' Mind Game. That movie being 3 hours long kinda made sense at the time, but looking back on it, nah, it really fucking didn't need to be that long. But it's gotten to the point where that's the status quo. If you have a huge blockbuster coming out and it's not 2.5 hours long, it's almost like you're doing something wrong. When we take into account the audience's attention span, it also becomes extremely interesting. The number one app in the world right now is TikTok, and those videos are averaging 15 seconds. So why do we have to have movies that are 100 times that length? The average song length has also shortened in recent history. So what excuse do directors have? Movies are now getting to the point where you have to plan your entire day around watching them. Like, you can't just go casually to the theater. Give me more 30-minute French art house films, please, like Jukar. He's Literally Me is the tagline of 2023, and with that comes all the overacting in the world. While there's a place for high-tension, dramatic acting, it's almost become overdone and contrived. Everyone and their mom are creaming over scenes of Ryan Gosling or Jake Gyllenhaal screaming at someone. Like, I understand, you girlfriend, but it doesn't mean it has to be in the majority of movies. We are slowly losing subtle acting, which is expressing emotion, not using huge gestures. We're getting to the point where every scene needs to end with someone pulling a gun out and killing a TV host to get the character's point across. I understand people want characters to sympathize with, but I don't think a deranged clown or some guy who drives a car are the best examples of characters to sympathize with. I think the amount of overacting from actors nowadays has a lot of blame on the amount of pressure put on them to perform at an extremely high level. Like, Joaquin Phoenix has to literally drop so much weight to the point where it is literally his health going down the drain so he can dress up as a clown. If your main source of inspiration is from a man who lost his leg in a tragic accident and had to slowly gain back the trust of his wife and family, then you should probably just go do your homework. And lastly, you are not Drive. Stop saying you're Drive.
Bruh, movies be gray as fuck nowadays. I thought we moved away from black and white films like 50 years ago, but give it like 20 years, we will be right back there. It's so depressing to go watch a movie and the palette be so many different shades of throw up. There are still directors who give a shit about color, and for those guys, pat yourself in the back. For the rest of you, I want you to go back to elementary school and learn the color wheel while strapped to the same chair as the dude from The Clockwork Orange. A movie should be colorful, vibrant. It should enhance the visual experience, make me want to keep watching. So if your movie looks like ass, it's gonna make me want to actually go outside and look at and touch real grass. Fuck that. I want to have so much color in my movie that it makes your dad's acid trips back when he was in high school look like kid shit. I want a movie with so much color, it makes your aunt's closet look fucking weak. I want so much color, it makes Rick Owens want to actually put some color into his fashion taste. A movie with a lack of color is like a college student with a lack of ambition. Nobody cares how sad you are. Nobody cares, you know, what you're doing. Wear at least like green or red, like once a month. I'm not saying your movie has to make your art teachers horny, but given some thought, I think Mrs. S would really appreciate it if you did. We ball.